This video will introduce you to concept maps. Concept maps are an excellent way for you to manually visualize the connections between items in your project and also to bring in your own thoughts and notes. To create a new concept map, head to the Explore ribbon and choose the Maps button and select Concept Map. The new concept map window will open and you can give your new map a name. I'm going to call this Fishing Industry Decline. And then click OK. My new concept map opens. You'll see I've got the option to add shapes or to add project items. I'm going to start off by adding some project items. I can also do this by dragging and dropping. So I'm heading into the coding area and choosing the codes folder. I'm going to drag in Fishing Industry Decline and I'm going to drag in these sub-themes. You'll notice, unlike the project map, the connections are not automatically popping up between these. For a concept map, I have to do this myself. So I'm first going to rearrange these different ideas. I can then switch from the pointer to the connector tool. And I can start to draw those connections onto this map myself. The advantage of this kind of map, switching back to the pointer, is that I can also add shapes. So for example, I can see here that we have regulation and the cost of doing business. I can really see how both of these link to policy, and I want to represent this on the map. So I'm going to drag in this upwards triangle and place it between the two. I'm going to make this a little bit bigger, and then I can double click on here and type policy. I can click on any shape, I can change the font, I can change the size, and I can change the shape colours and the border colours. I could even bring in some further themes, such as community change, and link this to tourism by using the connector tool again. You'll notice that when you have made a connection like this, you can use the pointer tool to select the arrow. You can then choose the change connector tool to change from a one-way to a symmetrical or associative relationship. I'm going to change this to symmetrical. I'm then going to further refine this diagram a little bit more and use another shape to bring in a further idea. Just as before, I can rearrange the shape, I can rearrange the size of this shape, and I can rearrange and choose the colours of the border and of the shape itself. Zooming in, you can now start to see how this diagram is mapping out the pressures between policy, the environment, and fishing industry decline. Just like any other visualization in NVivo, I can right click and select Export Map. Remember, this map is saved under Visualizations in the Maps folder. You can see other examples of concept maps in here in the Environmental Change Down East project, such as this concept map that maps the complexity of views on development. Now you're ready to start making some concept maps of your own.